बच्चों, क्या हालचाल? सो टुडे वी आर डिस्कस अबाउट रे ऑफ टिप्स पार्ट टू, द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ द प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम नीट. वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस द फर्स्ट पार्ट. द वीडियो लिंक ऑल्सो गिवन इन डिस्क्रिप्शन एंड द फर्स्ट कमेंट ऑल्सो. सो चलिए शुरू करते हैं. यस, आई एम सुधा सामंत एंड दिस इज योर प्यारा यूट्यूब चैनल एवरीथिंग. चलिए शुरू करते हैं. सो टुडे वी डिस्कस फ्रॉम क्वेश्चन नंबर 27. The question mentioned here, the angle of prism is A, one of its refracting surface is silvered. Light rays falling on an angle of incidence 2A on the first surface returns back through the same path after suffering reflection at the silver surface. So they asked you to calculate the refractive index mu of the prism. So they give you a prism whose angle of refraction is A and angle of incident, this is 2A. That means here I equals to 2A, right? And also mention here one surface is silvered. So this surface is silvered. That means light is reflected from this surface. We know if light rays go through direction and after refraction from the first surface of the prism, it goes this direction, and after reflection again travel in the same path. We know if this angle is angle of incident, so this angle is angle of refraction, that means R, right? We know from Snell's law, mu equals to sin I by sin R, right? And also here, this angle of refraction R equals to A. R equals to A. So just put this value. So sin 2A divided by sin A. And you know, sin 2a we can express as sin 2a equals to 2 sin a cos a, right? So just put this value here. So here we can write as 2 sin a cos a divided by sin a. So look here, sin a sin a cancel out. So the remaining part are 2 cos A. So this is the right answer, and from the given option, option B is the right, 2 cos A. Okay. Next we discuss the question number 35, because this comes from ray optics part. Plane mirror are inclined at 70 degree, a ray incident on one mirror at angle theta after reflection falling on the second mirror, and it is reflected from there parallel to first mirror. So there are two plane mirror inclined at 70 degree. One is just like that, another is here, right? So as here given, after reflection falls on second mirror, that means this mirror, right? At first ray comes and reflect this mirror, and after reflect this mirror. So this is the second mirror, and is reflected from there parallel to first mirror. That means if ray comes this direction after reflection this, and after this parallel to this. So they asked you to calculate the value of theta. Theta is the angle of incident. This angle is given 70 degree. Angle between two plane mirror. Okay, the rays fall just like that. We suppose from the perpendicular, this angle is theta, because this is the, this indicates the angle of incident, and after reflection it passes this direction, right? And we know from the laws of reflection, angle of incidence equals to angle of reflection. That means this angle also theta, right? after reflection from the second mirror, this passes parallel to first mirror. Okay, that means from this mirror the normal is passes here. This is the normal. Okay, for particular this case, if this angle 70 degree, that means this angle also 70 degree. So what is the value of the remaining part? The addition of the three angle 180. That means 180 minus 70 plus 70. That means 40 degree. So this angle is 40 degree. If you intersect a line, then this angle same. So if this 70, this also 70. From this particular symmetry, we can say that this angle also 70. Because if you look at the ray diagram, we discuss if this theta, this also theta, that means this angle equals to this angle. So here just apply this logic here. If this angle is 70, this angle also 70, that means this angle also 70. This and this angle, right? From this diagram, particular this angle is 90. So 90 degree equals to theta plus 40. So you can easily get the value of theta. That means theta equals to 50 degree. So from the given option, the right answer is option D, 50 degree. The values of theta. Okay. Next, the question given 36. This is basically a theoretical question. For this particular question, we have nothing to calculate, but we have just applied some basic theory. When a biconvex lens, biconvex, that means that two refracting surfaces are convex. Biconvex lens of glass having refractive index 1.47 dipped in the liquid. It acts as a plain sheet of glass. This implies that the liquid must have refractive index. What? So, for this particular problem, a liquid is available here. Here available liquid. You imagine you drop a lens, and after imagine this liquid, the lens is vanishes. That means the refractive index of the medium and the refractive index of the lens are same. This is the only possible cause for the light passes through this in the same direction. Because if the refractive index of liquid and the glass are different, then the light rays should change the direction. The right option, option A, equal to the glass. Next, we discuss about question number 37. A ray of light is incident at an angle of incidence I on one face of the prism of angle A, assumed to be small. That means their angle of prism are very small. So you can easily say this is a thin prism. Okay, next, and emerges normally from the opposite face. If the refractive index of the prism is mu, the angle of incidence I is nearly equals to what? So for this particular case, you can take a thin prism, because here mentioned angle of A is small, okay? And light rays are passing incident this direction. And here mentioned for the second surface, the light rays falling normally. For this particular case, R2 equals to 0, that means A equals to R1. Again, you know the Snell's law of refraction, mu equals to sin I by sin R. Okay. So this can written as sin I divided by sin A. They asked you to calculate the value of I, right? That means sin I equals to mu into sin A. and also the angle of incident is small. That means I is very small, A also very small. So you can suppose sin I approximate I, sin A approximate A. So I equals to mu. This is the right answer, and from the given option, option A is the right, mu into A. So now we discuss question number 40. For the angle of minimum deviation, that means delta M, angle of minimum deviation of a prism to be equal to its refractive angle, that means A equals to delta M, the prism must be made of material whose refractive index lies between what? So for this particular case, as we know, mu equals to sin A plus delta M by 2 divided by sin A by 2. And also mention here, angle of prism equals to minimum deviation. So you can put del M as A. So sin A divided by sin A by 2, mu equals to. Okay, we can write sin A as 2 into sin A by 2 cos A by 2 divided by sin A by 2. Okay, you can cancel out sin A by 2 sin A by 2. So mu equals to 2 cos A by 2. But this is not the answer because any option doesn't indicate that. Okay. They asked you to calculate the minimum and the maximum possible value of mu. Okay, so for minimum deviation, okay, we know another relation, delta equals to I1 plus I2 minus A. For minimum deviation, I1 equals to I2. So this is I1 equals to I2. So we can write as 2I1 minus A. From there, you just calculate value of I1. So 2I1 equals to delta, here delta M, because only for minimum deviation this happened, plus A, and also A equals to delta M, so this equals to 2A, so I1 equals to A. For minimum possible value of incidence, that means I1 equals to 0. You say what is the minimum possible value of I, this would be 0. If I1 equals to 0, then A equals to also 0, because this is the minimum value, I minimum, I mean, right, A mean. From this equation, if we put the value, we get mu max, maximum, because if the value of the theta portion is minimum, then the cos theta value indicates the maximum. So here, from this equation, we get mu maximum. So mu maximum equals to 2 cos A equals to 0, that means 0 by 2. So 0 by equals to 2 cos 0. Cos 0 means 1. So maximum possible value of mu is 2. Now I have to calculate the minimum value of mu. So for this, we take maximum possible value of I max. You say what should be the value of the maximum angle of incident? Maximum possible value of angle of incidence is 90 degree. That means A max equals to also 90, because they are equal. So from there we get mu minimum. So 2 cos 90 by 2, that means 45. So 2 into 1 by root 2, that means root 2. So you get the value maximum to minimum root 2. That means the value of mu lies between root 2 and 2. So from the given option, right answer is option B, lies between 2 and root 2. Okay, now we discuss question number 41. a rod of length 10 semi lies along the principal axis of a concave mirror of focal length 10 semi in such a way that its end closer to the pole is 20 semi away from the mirror. So they asked you to calculate the length of the image. As I mentioned, they take a concave mirror. This is a concave mirror whose principal axis lies here. This is the principal axis, you know. We suppose this is the focal point of the mirror F, and here given the focal distance is 10 semi, right? Again, here a rod is placed along the principal axis whose closure pole placed at a distance of 20 semi. That means if this distance 10, so this distance is 20, so from there a rod is placed. Rod is placed along the principal axis. So this distance is 20 semi, and also mentioned the length of the rod is 10 semi, right? This distance is 10. If this distance is 20, so what is the value of this? This is 30. So this distance is 30 semi. So they asked you to calculate the size of the image. This is the size of the object, 10 semi. Okay, you know, if the focal length is 10 semi, so what is the value of the radius of curvature R? 20 semi. So this portion of the rod placed at the center of curvature. So this portion image also remain on the same point, because we know for any concave mirror, if we placed a object at the radius of curvature C, the image also from there, right? But this portion object image shifted there. We know lens formula, 1 by F equals to 1 by V plus 1 by U. U is given here, F value also indicate negative, U also negative. We can easily put the value of F and U. So we have to calculate V. That means 1 by V equals to 1 by F minus 1 by U. You can put this value as negative, but this is not important here because all the values are here negative. So ultimately the result remains in the same. Okay, so you just take all the value positive. That means F value 1 by 10. You take the largest distance, the far point of the rod, that is 30. So you can easily calculate that 30, 3 minus 1, that means 2 by 30, that means 1 by 15. So V equals to 15 semi. So the far point object image now placed at 15 semi. 15 semi means between 10 and 20. So now the image position just like that. This is the image size, image position, and this position distance is 15 semi. This is like from 15 to 20, that means 5. 20 semi minus 15 semi, that means 5 semi, right? So from the given option, correct answer is option D, 5 semi. The next question given here, question number 42, this question based on theoretical purpose. We have nothing to calculate, so the question given is, which of the following is not due to total internal reflection? Okay, first option, option A, working of optical fiber. Option B, difference between apparent and real depth of a pond. Option C, mirage on hot summer days. Option D, brilliance of diamond. তুমি বলো এর মধ্যে কোনটা অভ্যন্তরীণ পূর্ণ প্রতিফলনের ফলে হয় না। ওকে, দ্য ভেরি নেক্সট কোশ্চেন 43। এ বাইকনভেক্স লেন্স হ্যাজ এ রেডিয়াস অফ কার্ভেচার অফ ম্যাগনিচিউড 20 সেমি। হুইচ ওয়ান অফ দ্য ফলোয়িং অপশন ডিসক্রাইব বেস্ট দ্য ইমেজ ফর্মড অফ এন অবজেক্ট অফ হাইট 2 সেমি প্লেসড 30 সেমি ফ্রম দ্য লেন্স। আই প্লেসড এ বাইকনভেক্স লেন্স হুজ রেডিয়াস অফ কার্ভেচার আর ইকুয়ালস টু গিভেন 20 সেমি। দিস ইজ দ্য ফোকাস, দিস ইজ দ্য ডবল ফোকাস। হেয়ার উই হ্যাভ টু অ্যাপ্লাই লেন্স মেকার ফর্মুলা, ওয়ান বাই এফ ইকুয়ালস টু মিউ মাইনাস ওয়ান ইন্টু ওয়ান বাই আর ওয়ান মাইনাস ওয়ান বাই আর টু। ফর দ্য ফার্স্ট সার্ফেস দ্য রেডিয়াস অফ কার্ভেচার ক্যাপিটাল আর প্লাস ক্যাপিটাল আর, ফর দ্য সেকেন্ড মাইনাস আর। সো মিউ মাইনাস ওয়ান ইন্টু টু বাই আর। অ্যাজ হেয়ার মেনশন দ্য লেন্স ইজ মেড উইথ গ্লাস, সো উই নো দ্য রিফ্র্যাকটিভ ইন্ডেক্স অফ গ্লাস নিয়ার অ্যাপ্রক্সিমেট 1.5। সো 1.5 মাইনাস ওয়ান, দ্যাট মিন্স 0.5, 0.5 মিন্স হাফ, হাফ ইন্টু টু বাই আর, দ্যাট মিন্স 1/r। সো এফ ইকুয়ালস টু আর অ্যান্ড গিভেন আর ইকুয়ালস টু 20, দ্যাট মিন্স এফ ইকুয়ালস টু 20 সেমি। ওকে, দে আস্ক টু ক্যালকুলেট দ্য নেচার অ্যান্ড দ্য সাইজ অফ দ্য ইমেজ, দ্যাট মিন্স ইউ হ্যাভ টু অ্যাপ্লাই লেন্স ফর্মুলা, 1/v প্লাস 1/u ইকুয়ালস টু 1/f। ফর লেন্স দিস ইজ মাইনাস 1/v মাইনাস 1/u। সো ফ্রম দেয়ার 1/v ইকুয়ালস টু 1/f প্লাস 1/u, বিকজ দ্য অবজেক্ট ইজ প্লেসড হেয়ার, ইমেজ ইজ প্লেসড এনি পজিশন ইন ফ্রন্ট অফ দ্য লেন্স, অ্যান্ড দ্য ফোকাল লেন্থ অলওয়েজ ইন ফ্রন্ট, বিকজ হোয়েন প্যারালাল রাইট গোজ আফটার পাসিং থ্রু দিস পয়েন্ট, দ্যাট মিন্স হেয়ার এফ অলসো পজিটিভ, রাইট? সো এফ ভ্যালু গিভেন 1/20 প্লাস ইউ গিভেন 30, বাট হেয়ার মাইনাস 30, দ্যাট মিন মাইনাস 30। সো ইফ ইউ ক্যালকুলেট 60, 3 - 2, দ্যাট মিন্স 1/60। সো ভি ইকুয়ালস টু 60 সেমি। ইজিলি দ্য ম্যাগনিফিকেশান এম ইকুয়ালস টু ভি বাই ইউ। ফ্রম দিস ডাটা ইউ ক্যান ক্যালকুলেট ম্যাগনিফিকেশান এম ইকুয়ালস টু ভি বাই ইউ, দ্যাট মিন্স ভি হেয়ার 60, ইউ 30, দ্যাট মিন্স 2। এগেইন উই নো আই বাই ও ইকুয়ালস টু এম, সো ফ্রম দেয়ার ইউ ক্যান ক্যালকুলেট দ্য হাইট অফ দ্য ইমেজ, সো আই ইকুয়ালস টু এম ইন্টু ও, এম ইজ 2, ও গিভেন অবজেক্ট হাইট 2 সেমি, দ্যাট মিন্স 4 সেমি। সো ফ্রম দ্য গিভেন অপশন দ্য ইমেজ মাস্ট বি রিয়েল ইনভার্টেড অ্যান্ড দ্য উইথ হাইট অফ 4 সেমি, অপশন সি ইজ দ্য রাইট অ্যান্সার, অপশন সি।